Shalom and good evening. This is TV7 Israel News, broadcasting to you from Jerusalem. And in today's top stories, an airstrike against a Syrian military airbase reportedly destroys an Iranian Revolutionary Guard surface-to-air missile silo in a precision-guided airstrike that Syrian and Iranian media outlets attributed to Israel. French President Emmanuel Macron announces a decision by Paris and Moscow to establish a coordinated mechanism that will seek to end the bloody conflict in Syria. Israeli Ambassador to the United Nations Dani Danon informs the UN Security Council that Iran had carried out two ballistic missile tests in January, a clear violation of UN Security Council Resolution 2231. Syrian, Russian, and Iranian media outlets reported an alleged Israeli airstrike against Syria's Dabaaz military airport that is located near the western city of Homs. The responsibility for the attack was attributed to Israel after reports surfaced regarding activity of Israeli fighter jets above Lebanese airspace, which is frequently used by Israel to carry out attacks against Iranian installations in Syria. While Syrian military officials claim that all of the missiles that were fired at the military airport were intercepted by the Syrian air defense systems and that the airport had not been damaged, Syrian opposition officials, however, released a statement claiming the following: an Israeli attack destroyed an Iranian Revolutionary Guard surface-to-air missile base in the airport. According to that report, the attack resulted in a large number of casualties, including members of the Iranian Revolutionary Guards and Hezbollah militiamen. Israeli officials refused to comment on the matter, yet a military official familiar with Israel's operational proceedings told TV7 on condition of anonymity that Israel will continue to act to assure its security interests are preserved and will use all means necessary, especially against those that seek to annihilate the Jewish state. Meanwhile, south of the Syrian capital of Damascus, the Syrian Arab army, together with its allies, entered the Hajar al-Aswad neighborhood and the Palestinian Yarmouk refugee camp that, after 7 years since the Al-Qaeda-linked Nusra Front and the Islamic State have captured those territories. The capture of those territories effectively ends any control the Islamic State had in the Damascus surrounding areas. That said, the Islamist militants have managed to establish a broad network of tunnels with improvised explosive devices that make it increasingly hard on Assad's forces to prepare the area for habitation.
تحرير الحجر الأسود وما حول الحجر الأسود أي المخيم من مجموعات داعش الإرهابية والمجموعات الإرهابية الأخرى وبهذا تصبح مدينة دمشق وريف دمشق وما حولها منطقة خالية من الإرهاب بشكل كامل
واجهنا شوية صعوبة بالأنفاق وبالدشم الأرضي المحكم لجميع خط الدفاع السابق جبهة نصرة طبعا كان اكثر شيء المفخخات والعبوات الناس فيه كانت موجوده بكل زاويه من كل غرفه من كل غرض مناطق لا تخطر على بال بني ادم.
The fierce battles that persisted for the last 32 days between the Syrian military and the Islamic State was clearly portrayed by the aftermath destruction as residents entered the devastated neighborhoods to inspect the damage to their homes. One of the residents of Yarmouk, which houses the largest Palestinian community in the war-torn country, emphasized that while the residents of the last fallen bastion of the Islamic State in the Damascus area were Palestinians, their true loyalty lies with Syria, that is perceived by them as their second home.
أنا فلسطينية مزبوط بس إحنا خلقنا هون سوريا بلدنا الثاني خلقنا هون ربينا هون.
Meanwhile, in the Russian city of St. Petersburg, French President Emmanuel Macron, who held extensive talks with his Russian counterpart Vladimir Putin, announced a decision by Paris and Moscow to establish a coordinated mechanism that will seek to end the bloody conflict in Syria.
Sofia, niveau européen, nous avons souhaité, comme l'a dit le président Poutine, mettre en place un mécanisme de coordination entre le groupe d'Astana et le small group. C'est pour moi une avancée très importante en termes de gestion du dossier syrien. Nous pouvons avoir des sensibilités différentes, c'est sûr, mais nous avons une même volonté de stabilisation, un même respect de la souveraineté des peuples, une même volonté de faire aboutir le dossier en étant inclusif et en construisant la stabilité à long terme.
The French leader further underscored a change since 2017 of French political forces that have altered Paris's position on Syria and its aspired future.
Le mois de mai 2017, notre politique, C'est celle qui consiste à construire une solution politique inclusive qui permettra d'élaborer le cadre constitutionnel qui permettra à tout le peuple syrien, y compris les Syriens ayant dû fuir, de voter et de choisir pour leur gouvernant.
With regard to the nuclear agreement with Iran, President Macron emphasized Europe's resolve in preserving the 2015 nuclear agreement. It indicated an ongoing attempt to negotiate with the Islamic Republic additional issues that Paris wants to see included, including Tehran's ballistic missile program and its aggressive policies across the Middle East.
Donc, nous sommes tous les deux d'accord pour dire nous défendons l'accord de 2015. Nous sommes, je crois, pouvoir le dire tous les deux d'accord pour dire nous devons élargir les sujets de discussion avec l'Iran. Nous sommes tous les deux d'accord pour dire il est indispensable de préserver l'efficacité et le cadre de 2015 pour être crédible dans cette négociation.
Russian President Vladimir Putin, on his part, declared Moscow's appreciation of Europe's efforts to preserve the nuclear deal with Iran, despite the decision by the United States to withdraw from the agreement. The Russian leader further took the opportunity to warn of lamentable consequences if the nuclear agreement would collapse.
Все взятые на себя обязательства Иран выполняет. В этой связи возникает вопрос, где основания для разрушения этой сделки и этой договоренности. Последствия, на мой взгляд, могут быть весьма плачевными, но мы приветствуем настрой не только Франции, но и всей Объединенной Европы, направленный на сохранение этой сделки.
Now to the United Nations headquarters in New York, where the Israeli ambassador to the world body, Dani Danon, informed the UN Security Council that Iran had carried out two ballistic missile tests in January in a clear violation of UN Security Council Resolution 2231, which specifically calls upon Iran in paragraph 3 of Annex B not to undertake any activity related to ballistic missiles designed to be capable of delivering nuclear weapons, including launches using such ballistic missile technology. Ambassador Danon wrote in his letter to the Security Council members the specifics of the Iranian ballistic missiles test, in which it fired two missiles, one Shihab-3 missile from a base in the southern part of the Islamic Republic, and a Scud missile from a base 110 kilometers northeast of the city of Kerman. Danon underscored in his letter that the missiles tests were part of Iran's repeated violations of the UN Security Council resolution, which also ratified the Joint Comprehensive Plan of Action, the technical term for the 2015 nuclear agreement with Iran. Danon further reiterated Israel's warning to the powerful body, in which Iran continues to ignore its commitment to the international community and has continued to destabilize the Middle East. Meanwhile, in the Austrian capital of Vienna, the remaining members that have formulated the nuclear agreement with Iran, including France, Britain, Germany, Russia, and China, have met today with the Islamic Republic's deputy foreign minister in a coordinated effort to save the deal following the decision by the United States to pull out of the multinational pact. As part of the strategy, the five world powers are seeking to keep agreements on oil exports and investments flowing with Iran to a level that will satisfy the Ayatollah regime to remain committed to the agreement that has limited Tehran's nuclear program in exchange for sanctions relief. The attempt by the five powers, however, to try and find a way to ensure Iran still receives economic benefits has proved difficult, with major European corporations frightened away by Washington's decision to reimpose international sanctions. Thank you for watching us. You can also watch us at tv7israelnews.com or tv7.fi. For any comments, please send your emails to israelnews@tv7.fi. For more updates from Israel and the region, please join our Facebook page at TV7 Israel News. Praying for the peace of Israel and the peace of Jerusalem. Jonathan Hassan, have a Erev Tov and Shabbat Shalom. We will see you again on Monday at the same time.